Hello, folks, and welcome back to the Vertigo Tea Party and Let's Play Dark Souls 3. Today's episode is brought to you by Travis the OJ. Thank you very much, Travis, for your continued support on Patreon. I very much appreciate it. So, let's continue in the Profane Capital. I am extremely pleased that we are not in... hopefully never gonna have to deal with that stupid bullshit with the poison again. If we do, it'll be too soon. Oh shit, I was gonna try the cell keys, wasn't I? Tell you what, guys, I'm really curious about that. Let me go ahead and head over there. I'll see you then. Okay. I also realized I could just start recording all over, pretend I never forgot, but that's no fun. Alright, let's see what we got going on in here. Nice chair. Prisoner Chief's Ashes. Ah, shit. Looks like when we go back, we turn those in. What do we say about the Prisoner Chief's Ashes? Not today. Oh, well, actually, yesterday. Umbral Ash of the Prisoner Chief of the Catacombs. With this, the Shrine Handmaid will prepare new items. The Prisoner Chief used his clout to hoard all manner of things, but died without putting them to use. Prisoner Chief. So, wait. Is he a chief who was a prisoner? Or he was just the... Chief prisoner. I mean, he's got a nicer chair. Ah, damn. So nice, I can't even destroy it. Oh, I didn't destroy it or killed everything around. I'm trying to remember all the cells we couldn't open. There's one area over here that I was specifically going this direction. Because I know there's that one cell with all the shit that transforms. And there's the one asshole in here. That door's open already, I believe. Yep, we're not gonna fuck with that, because there's no points. These guys transform. Later, you keep doing your thing. Alright, so let's go to the other side real quick and check those. And I love the spear against those, like, the cages with all the enemies in it. I love the spear for that. Ah, hello. Is this a shortcut? Oh! What? Okay. Jailbreaker's key. Oh, shit. So I could have came over here a long time ago. I mean, it doesn't really do anything for me now. But shit. Well, damn. Again, I wouldn't have really mattered because I would have wanted to do everything anyway. But, you know. Whatevs. Alright, so we're gonna need to check down there, so... there does seem to be a range on how far away they can do that shit to you. As soon as I see my health drop, I'll move. You almost got me. Alright. I don't remember if there's... Oops. I don't remember if there was anything down here. Oh, yeah, you. Ahem. I know there's the beard baby thing. But he doesn't even attack. Wait, what? Wait, what? Oh, there he is. I was like, wait a minute. Alright. We'll leave that be, because it's locked, or it's not locked, obviously. It's locked, but it's wide open. It's the weirdest thing. I still don't understand what the they need to explain what the different colors mean. Like, what the fuck is the purple summon sign? Like, what does that do? Dead end. Thanks. That totally deserves the 41 appraisals it's got. Alright. You know what, this room is going to be take a little bit to clear out. Let me do that. Alright, so there wasn't any cells over there that were still locked. I know there's more, but I cannot remember where there's other cells at. Maybe down there somewhere? I really don't feel like looking. But yeah, if you guys still have any other cell doors that are closed that I've just forgotten about, tell me. Because I don't feel like clearing all that shit out because I hate this place. I did also find out, however, though... that there is an item over here that I missed, so this is not a complete waste of time. Bellowing Dragon Crest Ring. Greatly boosts sorceries. Nice. Special ring given to those who are deemed fit to undertake the journey of discovery in Vinheim, home of sorceries. Greatly boosts sorceries. Apropos to the Dragon School, the seal depicts an everlasting dragon. A bellowing dragon symbolizes the true nature of the consummate sorcerer. Alright. So should we just... Oh yeah, because... Oh wait, yeah, this doesn't go to Profane. It just goes to the area right before it. This does go to the area where there's a shitload of those guys, but like I said, I don't think that there was any cells over there. Again, if there's any cells, try to be as descriptive as possible when you tell me where they are. Because again, I don't feel like running all over Hell and Creation, especially just to find out that there's nothing there. So let's actually go back and turn in these ash and see what we can get. Depending on what we get from this, it may or may not have been worth all that.
Gracious, passing fine ash thou hast given. Let this ash bestow nourishment. I only hope these new
ones. Alright, you say the same thing every time. Well, usually. More embers. Wish you could bring the cost down of these freaking blooming purple moss clumps. Guess we gotta deal with more bullshit with the toxic stuff. Dagger. Scholar's Candlestick, I think we've seen that before. A war pick. So far, everything's looking pretty much the same. I also had checked it earlier to see if she was selling anything since we beat that boss, but I don't... Oh, Carla's coat. Oh, this is new. All right, Carla's pointed hat. Hat of the Dark Witch Carla. A sorcerer pointed hat is the signature of a heretical sorceress. Carla, however, always kept it close. Carla's coat. Coat of the Dark Witch Carla. The stained coat is torn and odorous, telling of a long journey and even longer imprisonment. It would be madness to wear such a thing. So maybe Carla was the chief prisoner then, or whoever was wearing it. Stained gloves are torn and odorous. Okay. Carla's trousers. Let's see. I'm gonna guess they don't give much resistance. Looks like that was it, just Carla's stuff. That might be, I'll probably end up buying that just because it looks cool at some point. Not right now, but we'll consider it. Let's go ahead and buy 2-3 of these. We've got a ton of arrows, honestly. And I've also considered going ahead and putting sharp on this spear. I really wish you could buy those upgrades.
One.
Let me double check something. If we've got two sharps, I'll probably go ahead and do it. No, only one sharp. See, if the game really wants you to go this route instead of having default scaling be worth a shit, I really wish they'd, you know, made it so you could buy the things. Again, even if they made them like 8,000 souls or something, I don't want to use it on the spear and then find something later that I'd rather have it on. Again, not that it really matters, because if I put sharp on this weapon, it gives 13 more damage. 13, that's it, with 40 dexterity. And to me, that's like a joke. Because the thing is already doing, it's like 200, it raises it from like 252 to 365 or something like that. It's like, so it's like not even 10% damage increase. Again, from having 40 dexterity. It just feels like at least Dex doesn't scale worth a shit in this game. And that's with a scaling on the spear. I think what's silly is you lose base damage. Like, I don't understand that logic. like the base damage of the weapon drops. It's like, well, you're kind of countering the entire point of having a scale baler better. Not fully, but good shot, genius. Oh, okay. Let's shoot up a little bit more. I don't think we're going to be able to take these guys out without a shitload of arrows. Wow. Oh, that'll help, though. God damn it. These are those goddamn... Just a different model for the same... Come on, man. That's really far away. I don't know if this is going to work. Because we didn't see damage numbers. And I definitely don't want to do this. Oh, God, there's four of these motherfuckers. You know what? Fuck it. Let's just go. I don't have the patience to sit there and fuck with that for a million years. I'm trying to see how fast it shoots. Oh, shit. I see that. Shoots really fast is the answer, by the way. Come on, bitch. Take your fucking time. Get your ass over here. What'd I just fucking say to you? You wanna target him? Thanks. Oh. Okay. Normally he'd been stunned there. But alrighty. Oh, maybe because he was in the air. Maybe it wouldn't stun him. I've got a guess we're gonna have to deal with that a few times. I just wanna see, like, what the reload speed is, basically. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000. About 4 seconds. Wonder if it tracks. Probably. Got out of line of sight? Yeah. Large soul of a weary warrior. What's up, bitch? God damn, these guys hit points. Alright. Oh, I see that. Eh? What about the other one? No? Alright. And they'll probably still come to life, but... What is that? Jesus. Did some people die in here? Is that the impression you're trying to give me? God. Fucking seriously? I have a feeling they won't all aggro at the same time, though. I wonder if they've got the same bullshit ability. Gladys has got ants in her pants again. Wow. Oh, I lost him! He must have left. You know, this feels so cheap, but fuck it. I mean. I don't have a good way to test if these are the same assholes. They're not turning red, so I don't think... Hey! She fell down! It's like playing a stealth game. Like, they find the body and you kill them. And then another guard hears it and comes to check on the... finds the body. I could kill this one. Normal. But... Why bother? Hey-gah! Butthole. Handmaid's dagger. Ooh. Aha! And that's why I didn't. Because I knew you'd do this shit. Sup, bitch? You motherfucker. No, you're coming back down here. You are coming back down here because you are not stealing my goddamn plunge attack, you piece of shit. Get your fat, stony, fiery ass back down here right fucking now. No, don't hide. I could stay in here all day. Technically, you can too. Hey! Bitch! Don't fucking sass me, you motherfucker. Get your ass down here! No, I'm getting that drop attack. Get your ass. Hey! Come on. No, don't you go. Now you stay right fucking there. For now, and then you come over here, and I'm gonna drop attack you. We're gonna do this thing. Fuck you. Thank you. Yes, please. Kick. When he staggers, that's pretty much it for him. See, I knew they'd pull some bullshit like that. That's one of the reasons I killed his ass with, killed these with arrows. Because I knew some horseshit was going, ah ha ha, we got a slime or something's gonna jump out of it. Isn't that funny? The guess from, you guys are comedians in the wrong damn business. Ah, I thought I found like a little nook over there I could jump to and there'd be something cool, but no, no. So what was going on here? We were having like a mega freaking Tupperware party and things went really, really south. How many more of these stone dealies are we gonna get that's gonna, like, surprise and shock us? Motherfucker! How many of these do you need? What's up, ladies? Great. Now there's the wandering one. Wait. Hurry. You're gonna have to waddle faster than that, bitch. Alright, we need to find out what these can do. Yo, she bitch. Oh, we didn't look at the dagger. Okay. I don't know what that was. Oh, okay, these guys aren't too bad. Well, so far. But did we ever look at the pickaxe? A tool used by digging up earth, not intended for battle. Yet the strong downward swing of the tool once shattered large boulders and easily punctures weaker armor. Galvanized, temporarily boost stamina recovery speed by sheer force of will, which an old miner needed to get through the day. Where's that dagger at? Handmaid's dagger. Dagger used by handmaids of the profaned capital. Each successful attack replenishes a slight amount of FP. Ah, that's cool. It's said that these women took pleasure in wounding others. Skill, blind spot. Use against shielded foes to break through their guard by attacking from the side. I feel like we tried that before and it wasn't a very good ability. Oh wait, shit. You know, that thing could probably still shoot my ass. Let's pull them back. I don't know if it's something that, like... Boom! Oh my god. You can make it! No, almost. Right in the ice hole. Hello? Nobody here. I'm a handmaiden. I'm the new handmaiden. Ah! So you got a thing for fire, apparently. Hadouken! I knocked on her ass. Yeah, I think enemies with, like, really slow stamina. Or, low, whatever, like, can't, like, they get knocked down with a strength. God damn, 18,000 souls again! The game's giving us too many souls. It's not possible. Can I destroy this piece of shit? Fuck you. I want to give these guys a break. Ass. Alright, so I know there's the ladies to the side. Is this thing still going to fire at my ass? I'm probably too low for it. These guys are going to come alive. Come on. Are you going to wait till I pass you? Is that what you're doing? I'm on to you. I don't even think, we're from software. He'll never suspect these giant gargoyle statue things he's been fighting this whole fucking time. Shit. This guy's like, no, mom, I want to go back to bed. It's summer, spring break. Summer break. One of the breaks. They're gonna come to life. Guaranteed. I promise you. And if they don't, I will ban every single person who mentions that I was wrong. That way, it looks like I was right. Unless one comes from, like, beneath us or some shit. I'm trying to cover all my boundaries or all my options so that I'm right regardless. Life tips, kids. Also, swing the camera around a lot. It helps people get nauseous. They don't realize how bad you're playing. Probably shouldn't be running to the edges, by the way. Wait a minute. Please tell me he just... Good on you, mate. Good on you. Yeah, we're not gonna get as close as he did. I just wanted to check. Okay. Alright, now they're gonna come to life. Come on. Come on. You see that? Alright. Fine. I want to, like, where's the deactivate button on this? I don't want this thing ever to work again. Is that really a boss? Have we been through any fog doors in this game that have not been a boss? I don't believe so. God almighty. I definitely wish there were more of these. Again, we're doing the same thing because last time we had shit spawning all up in our shit. And I'd rather not fight all these at the same time. Obviously, if there's a boss over there, we're not going over there with what will be like 20,000 souls by the time we get done. I didn't even look at the stats of that dagger. I know this is super exciting for you guys, but again, haste makes waste and all that. Oh, they turn around like, it seems like something's amiss, and they've got like three arrows in their head. It's even more funny when their friends are just staring at them like they're idiots. Like, what's your fucking problem? Gladys is having one of their spells again. And they're just staring at the, oh, no, there's chests over there. Wait a minute, I have an idea. Please tell me what I'm hoping's about to happen is gonna happen. Oh, come on. You see that's a mimic, right? Oh god, please fight them. Oh. God, you are a fucking joy. Wow. Oh, that's why. Because I don't have my fucking shield equipped. Sweet. Nope, come on. Oh, I got lucky as fuck that he missed me there. Stairs saved my ass. Ha! Right between them skinny legs. Ooh, and that cute little ass. No, he's got no ass. We're just missing the shit out of each other here. This is kind of embarrassing for everybody involved. Symbol of avarice! Rusted gold coin, but more importantly, silver gold avarice. Symbol of avarice. I love this helm, but it really sucks. Because I'm sure they put the same bullshit on it again. Symbol of avarice. Head of the avaricious creature that mimics treasure chests can be worn if one so wishes. Increases soul absorption from defeated enemies, as well as item discovery, but the curse of the branded also drains hit points. The very form of this creature is thought to be a form of brand, a punishment for sin. Obviously, I'm not going to put it on right now. I will later. I was really hoping he would attack them. Like he would like take a swing or something. Let me try this. I get in and right, like get them in the way here. Aw. Thank you, stamina. You know, you think wood or fire would do like a lot of extra damage. Come on, I don't like fighting by that wall. Freaking bastards. Great Shield of Glory. Let's check out this item that we all definitely will not be using. With a name like Great Shield of Glory. What's this? 40 strength! A great shield adorned with flowing patterns, a celebration of an ancient glory. Boasts the highest stability of such shields, but with reduced stamina regeneration speed. Perhaps it is glory that begets indolence. Indolence? Shield bash. Without lowering your guard, strike the enemy with a shield to knock them back or stagger them. Works with, equipped with either hand. Sorry, cat was walking in front of me. 80 stability. Was there another chest over there? There is. Let's just kill these. And we'll go in. That way we ain't gotta worry about them aggroing on us or some shit. God damn it. I hate when they've got like no health left. Gonna run out of normal arrows here. I keep forgetting. I don't think the game automatically restocks shit, which kind of sucks. Jesus, oh, you've learned. Shoot the goddamn arrow. See, it did it again. Like, that thing I was telling you about in the other video. Where, like, I pressed to attack, and you've got stamina, but you just don't, like, do the thing. Hello. Y'all know what I'm doing, right? I think it's a regular chest. I can't see the chain on it. And I can't really take a minute to look. I was gonna say that should stagger. That one had a little bit more hit points, I think. Not enough. Holy shit, we're at 32,000. Fuck. I hate having this many souls. This is probably. Be wary of duo. Be wary of duo. Yeah, I know. The other one isn't marked. And I don't see the mouth moving. Where are the... Alright. What do we got? Ember. Okay. Of course, the one that wasn't a mimic. Because I think if you can... From what something I had read before, if you can get something to attack the mimic, the mimic will actually fight whatever attacked it. As much as I loathe the idea of coming back here, we're not even going down that fucking hallway. You guys know that shit. Not with 32,000. Not with enough to level. Not that getting here was a big pain in the ass. I mean, it took us a while. But now I understand how to get there. And it's 30 minutes, so that means we can try whatever, what appears to be the boss. Welcome next. Very well then taken. Alright, we're gonna go with endurance again. I might keep going endurance until it stops giving us two per. We'll see. And again, I kind of hate that we've switched up to going like shield and blocking all the time. But man, it's just like, it's so much better than rolling. Like, it's almost unarguably better. Like, it's just ridiculous how much better it is. Because rolling, you have a chance of, I mean, it still uses stamina, and you have a chance of mistiming, and a lot of times it puts you further away if you don't time it just right. Whereas blocking with a shield, a lot of times, you know, they could miss you, and it's easy to get a backstab if they miss you completely, or it's easy to work your way back around. So rolling doesn't seem to be the way to go. Like, I'm sure there's arguments for it, but just blocking is so much better. It's insane. But anyway, thank you guys for watching. Thanks again to Travis the OJ for your continued support on Patreon. Next video, I'll pick you guys up probably right at that wall or that fog wall, and we'll see what's behind it. I'm guessing it's a boss, because that path actually hasn't seen a boss in quite a while. So we'll see how it goes. Probably not as smooth as the other boss, the what's his face. So, anyway, thank you guys for watching. Leave comments, follow me on Twitter, and I'll see you next time.